When I was young, I had a lot of people telling me, you have to adjust to the other ones. You have to be like the other ones. I was listening, but I wasn't always following. I kept doing my own thing and I believed in myself. They judge you even before you come and they don't even know you. And that was outside the pitch and inside the pitch. But I kept going. I kept going and it brought me where I am today.
When we are kids, we want to be astronauts. We want to be billionaires. We want to be history makers. We want to do all our dreams. And we stand in awe and wonder. And we're full of curiosity. And we're loving. And we're passionate. And we're strong. We're not afraid to be ourselves. But as we leave the perfection of childhood, the hypnosis and the brainwashing begins. Our well-intentioned parents say, oh, you want to be an astronaut? You want to start a business when you grow up? You want to paint like Jean-Michel Basquiat? Be reasonable. And George Bernard Shaw said it better than I ever could. He said, the reasonable man adapts himself to the world. The unreasonable one persists in adapting the world to himself. Therefore, all progress depends on the unreasonable man.
As a kid, your imagination would be endless. Oh, I want to fly. I want to do this. I'm talking about unbelievable imagination. Imagination is destroyed by family members, others. People kill ideas. You got idea killers out here. A lot of times these kids, they can't grow into what they want to grow in because they live in environments where their ideas is beat up and where as though they got to suffocate their ideas and somehow they kill their ideas and they bury the ideas because they don't want to get laughed at or they're ashamed of them. So by me going to prison from 17 to 37, well, you know, experience life, lived experience, life will fucking destroy your imagination.
Why you think you keep imagining opening a business? Why you keep imagining graduating, getting a better job? Why do you keep imagining buying a house? Why do you keep imagining driving a really nice car? Why do you keep imagining getting rich one day? Why do you keep imagining that? Because God is talking to you. He's showing you something that he has for you.
People's opinion of you is none of your business, nor should you make it yours. You get in a lot of trouble worrying about what somebody think about you, when really, what difference do it make? Whether they wrong or right, what difference do it make? The majority of people who have a negative viewpoint of you really don't even know you.
You are responsible for your life. And if you're sitting around waiting on somebody to save you, to fix you, to even help you, you are wasting your time because only you have the power to take responsibility to move your life forward. And the sooner you get that, the sooner your life gets into gear.
I don't know what your future is, but if you are willing to take the harder way, the more complicated one, the one with more failures at first than successes, the one that has ultimately proven to have more meaning, more victory, more glory, then you will not regret it.